The open window, part 1. Framtona Tall was sitting in chair when the young lady entered the room. "My end will be done in 10 minutes," the young lady told Frampton very calmly. "She asked me to wait here with you until then." Frampton wondered what to say to the 15-year-old girl. He felt nervous, very nervous. Stranger always made him feel nervous. Waiting made him feel nervous. Talking made him feel nervous. Everything made him feel nervous. In fact, he had come to the country to calm his nerves. His sister had given him some advice. "I know just what you need," she had said. "Get away from the city for a while. A week in the country will be good for you. I'll give you the names of some nice people you can visit while you are there. Otherwise, you'll stay in your room all the time. You won't say a word to anyone, then your nerves will get worse than ever." Mrs. Ablinton was one of the nice people she recommended. Now Frampton waited for her to come down from upstairs. "Do you know many people around here?" the young lady finally asked. Her words broke a long silence. "I don't know any of the people around here," Frampton replied. "My sister visited this part of the country 4 years ago. She met your aunt, Mrs. Ablinton, then. My sister said that Mrs. Ablinton was very nice." "Then you don't know anything about my aunt?" the calm young lady asked. "Only her name and address," admitted Mr. Nuttall. He looked around the room and wondered whether or not Mrs. Ablinton was married. Something about the room suggested that a man lived there. "Her terrible tragedy happened exactly 3 years ago today," said the girl. "3 years ago today, that was after your sister was here." "Her tragedy?" asked Frampton nervously. "It didn't seem possible that terrible things could happen in this quiet, peaceful place." The niece pointed to the large French window that opened like a big door onto the lawn. She said, "You are probably wondering why we keep that window wide open on a day in October." "It is very warm for this day after here," said Frampton. "But does that window have anything to do with the tragedy?" "Yes," said the girl. "Just 3 years ago today, her husband and her two brothers went out on through that window. They were going hunting. They never came back, all three drowned in a storm. It had been a very rainy summer, you know, and places that had always been safe suddenly became dangerous. Their bodies were never found." That was the worst part of it. Here the girl's voice began to crack. "Poor dear Anne," said the girl. "She has never been able to get over what happened. She still believes that they will all come back someday. They and the little brown dog that went with them. She thinks they will walk in through that window the way they always did. That is why that window is kept open every day until it gets dark." The girl shook her head sadly. "Poor Anne. She has often told me how they went out. Her husband had his white raincoat over his shoulder, and Ronnie, her younger brother, was singing, 'London Bridge is falling down, falling down.' He always sang that to tease her because she said it got on her nerves. Do you know, sometimes on quiet evening like this, I get a strange feeling that they will all walk in through that window." The girl suddenly began to shake, and she stopped talking. Frampton was very glad to see the aunt enter the room.